listen to that purr. Mm-hmm. Wow. Do you want to do some licks? You just want to purr? Wow. These guys are so soft.
Yeah.
They're so soft. And they're just purring up a storm. Purring up a storm. I don't know if you guys knew that cheetahs purr, but boy, do they. Look at each other. Cleaning each other up a little bit. Look at that. And you see how they can have these spots and they can blend in with the different grasses and stuff. You can give me a kiss?
Yes, you got a kiss.
Give me a kiss? Mm-hmm. Wow, look at these guys. They have that really long tail right there, which helps them with balance when they're running. These guys are the world's fastest animal. On short distances, these guys can get up to 70 kilometers. And wow, look at this. Oh! I think they've accepted me. Oh, love bite.
Love bite. Did you get a love bite, Uncle Charles? Did you get a love bite, Uncle Charles?
So how old is this guy?
In April. She'll be three.
She'll
and this
be three?
Is Scarlet, yes. She's named after Gone with the Wind litter. Oh, good. Nice licky, Scarlet. Nice licks, Scarlet.
they both have Gone with the Wind names. This
yes.
is Scarlet and over
And Melanie
over here.
Behind you. So they've been separated. They were born in a litter of four. Two brothers, Rhett and Ashley. And they've been separated now so that they don't breed with their brothers because we're very strict with our breeding projects and we don't allow any inbreeding. We want the animals to be genetically as diverse as possible. But obviously it's quite difficult because with the bottlenecking of cheetahs, we've only got 1,200 cheetahs left in South Africa. And so obviously your genetic diversity has formed a bottleneck where they're all quite closely related. And so for that reason, if you have a group of animals within your conservancy or park that you're using, you make sure that they don't inbreed with their brothers so that they maintain their genetic diversity.
Yeah, so one
would mate them then with some other male that's totally unrelated to them.
And you're doing it in a way that preserves their genetics
yes.
so that we can restock the populations in the wild, potentially.
Yes, if there was enough place in the wild, which is shrinking.
Which is the big challenge. So
huge challenge, loss of habitat.
There's two challenges, keeping these
yes.
guys alive
yes.
in terms of the genetic diversity
yes.
and also having a place to put them.
That's right.
Because humans have been so much done so much destruction on their habitats, and
yes.
we've moved into everywhere.
Yes.
We are the most invasive species on the planet. We're moving in every ecosystem.
Humans are the biggest enemies to animals today, and there are some humans that are in some way or another trying to do something for the animals, for the preservation of the animals, and hopefully as many people as possible can come on board with that.
So another really important thing that you guys are doing here is you're trying to become the first place to artificially inseminate a cheetah.
That's right, yes.
And tell us why that's important.
Well, because again, the loss of genetics. If you can inseminate the animal, maybe there's less males. If you can save sperm, inseminate a female, she can produce cubs. Sperm can be saved, it can be used in many years' time. So the quality of sperm is not
so even if that male
lost.
Died, passed away, you can potentially still have them father some other offspring.
That's right, by storing sperm and then artificially inseminating the females. It's got huge implications.
And when you're less than around 1,000 cheetahs, That makes a big difference, being able to go out there and say, hey, this guy can father a lot more. You know, and you're not moving that cheetah and saying, pairing, and hey, let's see if you guys get along. Mm-hmm. It's, can we go ahead and get some of these mothers having offspring?
Yeah. Can you imagine Africa without these beautiful cats? It would be absolutely tragic. Eh? Look at those beautiful amber eyes.
Guys, this is out at Ukutula in South Africa, and I'm actually going to be tagging them in this post. I'll tag their social media so you can go out and follow them and see all the cool stuff that they are doing to help preserve cheetah populations.